if we could assume the same responsibilities in education, like in sports, or in sports like in education, we'd better get a better society. Now, I'm a point of saying our pickup is at one. Football is no distraction to education, never. Football is no distraction to economy, never. Football is no distraction to social cohesion, never. They go hand in hand, and football enhances all those objectives. Football is social investment. If you look at US, you look at Brazil, you look at China, everybody else, and those who are involved in the politics of football will also tell you that why was there such commotion before Russia 2018? Was the US angry that they needed to get a piece of that? Are they happy now that them and Canada are into it? Why are the politics around Qatar? Journalists, investigators will tell you there's a lot at stake when it comes to football. And KZN has brought that down, and they've realized that, and the rest of the other provinces are still sleeping. And the quicker they wake up, the better. Because sometimes we tend to be selfish and want to achieve as individuals and neglect a lot of people who are behind us. If I can only look at winning trophies and not bettering other people's lives, I'm actually killing the objectives of where I am. Yes, we must win trophies, but on the other side, you have a responsibility to serve as an educator and bring out all those human values. Now, we thank KZN, everybody else involved, and I hope whoever is involved in this, spectators, coaches, and us players, get the best out of it. Leave a memory so that when you look back and say, okay, the Premier's Cup last season, what happened? This season, what do I do? Then looking forward. Ngiyacela ke kubantu bethu ukuthi sometimes xa sikhohlwa ukuthi i-sports sisebenzani, you look at it not only political, not only in its religious form, not only from an economic part, not anyhow, but as a human being, ukuthi wena, what does it do for you? Sport has built my character. Sport has given me confidence to stand in front of 200 people and make a statement. I wouldn't have done that. I would never have had the confidence. I'm a better person because of sports. And if I had not gone to school and played sports, I would still stand here and make sense. A lot of players who have not gone to school, and we know how many of them are there, can still make a statement. They have a voice. They are listened to because of the profile that football brings to them. So I think they must take advantage of that. Apart from being role models, make a statement, sensible statement, so that others who cannot make such statements can benefit. So we are out here not only as sports people, but activists. Yeah. The day you suffer, and you suffer on behalf of everybody else, you're serving your purpose. The day you run away from suffering, wanting to save your soul, you destroy the rest of those who are behind you. Let us use sports to better other people's lives. Thank you.
I moved from Coach Steve to Maritzburg United. I noticed they also have a management coaching channel. We also have a media guy there, my friend. But let's ask Coach Eric Tinkler to come forward and have a few words. Yeah, it's like halftime TV talk. Like.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, MEC, dignitaries, coaches, clubs, journalists. Yeah, obviously for me, this is going to be my first Premier Club Cup involvement. Obviously, me being the type of person I am, I hope I can win this competition and start the season well. For us, obviously, we're in our pre-season right now. And it's always going to be very, very difficult for us as coaches in training to try and simulate a competitive match or a competitive competition leading up to the start of the league. And I think this cup competition obviously helps us immensely achieve that primary objective. I wanted to touch, when it comes to youth development, I wanted to touch a little bit on what Steve just mentioned, about it's not only about winning cups, it's also about developing young players. But we also need to look at the environment we live in today. It's a must-win environment. That's something that has been created, and it kind of makes it very, very difficult for coaches to take that risk, throwing in younger players. I think it's more the maturity in terms of the younger players having an understanding of the game. And in that area is obviously an area that we need to see a vast improvement. But I think it's no different to someone who comes out of varsity or out of college and goes into employment. And the first question they ask, how much experience do you have? Well, I have none because I've just come out of varsity. No different to a young footballer. The only way you can actually simulate that environment is by throwing him in the deep end, putting him in those matches. And like I said, unfortunately, because of the nature of the game and the nature of the beast, it becomes very, very difficult, not only for the player, but obviously also for the coaches, because the end of the day, the buck stops with us, you know? But obviously, I'm a big fan of youth development. I got my debut at the age of 17. I'd love to see more youngsters having that opportunity. We had a boy this season, Klongwani, age of 18, making his debut in the PSL. And the more we see that, I think that can only obviously benefit our national team in the future. So again, thank you for this opportunity. Looking forward to the tournament. Looking forward to the game against Arrows. We're not going to give anything away, Steve. We play each other very soon in the league, so we've got to be careful. Yeah? And yeah, and to the rest, good luck, obviously. Thank you.
So, Akulu from Real Kings, Coach Simulala, Sponila Nubaba Ongi to corner part way to Umpatu Kembu, so Akulu and the management team, Coach.
The rest of the staff at the sports ministry, the members of the media, the club chairman, Ngoketekile Babuhlomuka, the club captains, and the supporters at large, I greet you all. For us at Real Kings, it's the preparation for the start of the league. We are babies when it comes to football in this province. We're only 3 years old in the paid ranks. The objective is simple. We just want to see the final day. The tournament kicks off on the 27th, which is the Saturday. We just want to eliminate whoever we have to play on Saturday, so we see the next day. For the past 3 seasons, we've never failed in doing that. But of course, we've never lifted this trophy. I've also noticed that for the past 3 seasons, the team that has been able to eliminate us, they end up lifting the trophy. And hopefully, my charges will do better than that. But it's really not a main objective. The main objective is to see the next day, which is playing 290 minutes. We are still preparing. We just want to employ good habits. We're just excited to be rubbing shoulders with Golden Arrows, AmaZulu, Maritzburg United, Utongati, Royal Eagles, Richards Bay. I am more excited sharing the dugout with Steve Kompela, Kevin Johnson, Eric Tindler, Johnny Favela, Joel Masuta, and Brendan Trotter. I also have noticed that in the 7 teams, I am the only one from the KZN. That's all thanks to my chairman, Bongani Ngidi, who has empowered me, given me the strength from day one. to manage his investment. I couldn't have done this without his support, without his bravery. He has given me direction and strength. In front of everyone, I would like to appreciate you. Babungi. We try at Real Kings to have a number of young players. We try to look within and around the province first. I can stand here. I stand here filled with pride. We also have produced a few young players. Tumsani Zuma at Kaizer Chiefs comes from us. We also had Luvuyo Phewa representing the country at the World Cup. Now he's only 18 years old. And he's sought out after by a lot of teams, even abroad. We are very proud. In the 3 years, we have produced over 12 players that are playing regular football in the Premiership, different clubs. But then again, would like to appreciate the KZN government for this tournament, and we would love to see this tournament growing from strength to strength, in ensuring that football benefits and people of the province benefits. Thank you.